Jennifer.
Yeah.
Should we continue?
I was trying to forget.
Why are you trying to forget?
You know why I'm trying to forget. I've been coming to you for 6 months now.
Jennifer, I understand you're going through a very difficult time right now, but we're here to talk about the accident. These sessions are to help get your life back in order. You need to be open and honest with me.
An accident? Why do people keep referring to Sean's death as an accident? My brother was killed in a car crash. How is that an accident?
Well, regardless if it was a car crash or not, it was still an accident.
To me, an accident is breaking a glass or shrinking your clothes in the dryer. How is someone getting killed even remotely compared to those things?
I want you to understand there's all different forms of accidents. The severity of the accident depends on the situation.
I just don't understand why it happened. Why did Sean have to die? There has to be a reason.
In order for you to move forward, you need to accept what happened. Tell me about the accident.
Again? Please, I don't want to talk about it.
It's important, Jennifer. You said before you're trying to forget. If you continue to let yourself forget about the accident, you'll never be able to accept what happened that day. You'll never be able to move on with your life.
Okay. I remember it so clearly. It was November 10th. Sean called me that day to wish me a happy birthday. A few years ago, he moved away for a job opportunity. He was only 3 hours away, but I knew things would be different. We were always so close growing up. Anyways, Sean told me the most wonderful news on the phone that day. Told me he'd be coming home that weekend to celebrate my birthday. I was so happy. I never thought that would be the last day I would ever talk to him. The weekend had finally arrived, and I couldn't wait for Sean to get home. I got ready and waited, but he never showed. I was so angry with him. I couldn't believe he would do this. I just didn't know.
What didn't you know?
Around 2 a.m., we received a phone call. It was the police. Sean was driving home when his car hit a patch of ice and swerved down an embankment. They said he died on impact.
What did you do?
I didn't believe it at first. How could I? I just talked to Sean on my birthday. But then, it just hit me. Sean was never coming home again.
And how did this make you feel?
Angry, hurt, sad, alone. My brother, my best friend, was killed coming home to see me. At first, I blamed myself. I'd sit in my room for days, crying. Then, I just started to isolate myself from everyone, even my boyfriend. I wanted answers, but no one could give me any. So I became numb, because numb was the only way I could deal with this.
People will always want an answer for why it happened, but there isn't always an answer to give. We know how the car accident happened, but no one will ever know why it took Sean's life.
People get into car accidents every single day and don't die. I just don't understand why it had to turn out this way.
You're asking a question that'll never be answered. You need to move past that and accept that it was an accident. There's nothing that could have controlled what happened that night.
I just want to see him again. For a long time, I used to look forward going to bed. I would hope I would find him in my dreams.
And what happened?
Now my dreams haunt me. When I see Sean in my dreams, I can never reach him. No matter how hard I try, I can never get close enough. It doesn't matter how fast I run or how far I run. I can never catch up to him. And the worst part about these dreams is Sean himself. He's always blurry. I can never see him clearly. All of this scares me. Why can't I see him? Seeing him in my dreams was the closest thing I had to reality. And now I don't have that anymore.
I think you need to sit down and really ask yourself, why is this happening? 6 months have passed since the accident, and you become distanced from your family and your friends. You allow yourself to feel numb because you don't want to feel any emotion at all. If you continue this, you'll lose anything you have left as Sean. You need to ask yourself this very important question. Is it better to remember or to forget? Where are we? What the hell is going on? The dust has opened. Hey, how'd it go today?
It was okay.
Good, well, you want to go to dinner tonight? My treat?
Thanks for the offer, but I don't feel like going out to dinner.
Jennifer, you need to get out of the house. What you're doing is not healthy. Can you please look at me? I love you, Jennifer, but you seem to be slipping farther and farther away from me. I can't lose you, but I just don't know what else to do.
Can you bring me home now? I'm tired. I want to go to bed.
Jennifer.
Sean?
Jennifer, what are you doing?
What do you mean?
I mean, look at yourself. You look terrible.
I know, Sean, but it hasn't been easy since you left. I can't function without you. You're always a part of my life, and now? Now you're gone.
So you've given up?
Maybe.
Jennifer, I never left you. I may no longer be living here on Earth, but I've always been with you.
You haven't been with me since the accident.
That's not true. I know things didn't turn out the way we wanted them to, but we shared many years together. There are memories and moments that can never be taken away.
I know, but they hurt. I don't want to think about them. All they do is remind me of you being gone.
Please stop this. You're torturing yourself. Look, what happened was an accident, and I've accepted that. The last 6 months, I've watched you torture yourself every day. You need to know that I'm okay.
You're okay? How can you be okay?
You're my little sister, and I love you. You're so young, and your life is full of opportunity. My life here might be over, but yours isn't. I need you to be you again. Your friends and family miss you. I need you to be strong and live life to the fullest. Don't give up on life. Jennifer, look at me. This is important. I need you to let go. You need to hold on to the good memories and let go of the bad. I have something for you. I never had the chance to give you this, and I want to give it to you now. It's your birthday present.
As long as you have this, I'll always be a part of you.
It's beautiful, Sean. Can you help me put it on?
Of course.
I love you, Jennifer, and I'll always be with you, watching from above.
I love you, Sean. Here comes the sun, I say, it's all right.